Gemara, Mesechet Niddah, Perek Bet, Mishnah Gimel. Third Mishnah in the second chapter of Mesechet Niddah. So our Mishnah is a continuation of the end of the last Mishnah. In the last Mishnah, we said that if a woman, if a man and a woman, they engaged in intercourse and then they did examinations. If they found the stain immediately, then they're both Tmeim V'chayavim Korban. But the Mishnah said, Nimsal Shela Le'achar Zman, let's say she found later on, she found a stain on her cloth. Okay, then it says Tmeimi Safek, then the Tmei because it's Safek. Maybe she wasn't Niddah when they had intercourse, maybe not. Upterim in a Korban. So then they're an example of the Korban. What does it mean the Achar Zman? That's the topic of our Mishnah. Ezehu Achar Zman. How much longer must it be in order for that to remove the husband from the certainty that he was Boel Niddah, that he had intercourse with a woman who was Tmei'at Niddah, who was a Niddah? So the Mishnah, not long, the Mishnah says, Kedei Shetei Redi Min Amitah, with a diach panea, enough time for her to get out of bed. Et a diach panea means to wash her, means a panea shel mata, means for her to wash her genital area. Okay, if there's enough time for that to have happened, then within that period of time, then we assume the blood was from beforehand. But ve'achar kach, if she finds a stain on a cloth when she washes herself afterwards, we do not have to assume that she had stained before, but instead, we assume that she had stained after intercourse at the end. Mitam'a me'et le'et. Yes, for vis-a-vis kodshim, she's mitam'a backwards, but ve'ena mitam'a et bo'ala. But we do not apply that tuma to bo'ala, to the man, to her husband, who had marital relations with her. Now, the Bartunura says, ve'ena mitam'a et bo'ala tumat shiva. He's not Tamei, Tumat Shiva, he's not an Avatuma, Al Tumat Erev, Kidin Kol Nogea Benida, but it is Tumat Erev, we assume that he is Tamei Rishon the Tuma, like someone who touches a woman who's in Nida. So he's kind of like cognitive dissonance in a sense. Do we say that she was Tamei'a for Boel Nida? No, but for other Chashashot, yes. Rabbi Akiva says, Af Mitama et Boala. Rabbi Akiva says, no, I don't agree. Kiva says she also is mitamet et bo'ala. Her husband is also tamei'a, says the Bartunura. Why? Tisavar Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva says call me et le'et mitamet bo'ala. If we say that when she examines herself and she finds a stain, then it's reactive 24 hours. It's also mitamet bo'ala tumat shiva misafek. He said then it also applies to the husband. Logically, it makes sense. But the whole point of tumat et le'et is a chumra for kachim. So then the question is, do you then apply that chumra of kachim, that stringency of kachim, on the husband himself. Umodim chachamim the Rabbi Akiva b'ro'a ketem. The chachamim agree to Rabbi Akiva, if a woman sees a ketem is a stain on her clothing, she finds a stain of blood, shemetam'a et bo'ala, that she is mitam'a et bo'ala, that if he then sleeps with her afterwards. This is now, moving forward. Now remember, we said this idea of eid le'eid is a din de rabbanan. So Rabbi Akiva says, even though it's a din de rabbanan, we apply it to be mitam'a et bo'ala retroactively. But what about moving forward? So Nora, so if a woman's a Nida, Boel Nida is a Surah. But what happens if she saw Ro'ah Ketim? She didn't see, she didn't do an examination. Examination is as then she has a Dina of a De'oraita. But a woman who sees a Ketim, a stain, now that's Midrabanan. We say, okay, now you're a Nida. You saw a Ketim, it was the right proper size, the proper color. We're going to get into all that. Okay, but now Midrabanan, she's Oseret. Says the Bartanura, Avagab de Betuma me'eid le'eid. Regarding to a me'eid le'eid backwards. Amru Chachamim she'ena mitama et bo'ala. Chachamim said, no, her husband is not Tamei. Why? V'fish t'dumat me'et le'et ena ela midrabanan. Because the Tumah, retroactive Tumah is derabanan. Modim ein beruah ketem. Chachamim agree with him in the case where a woman saw a stain, not an examination. A ketem is she saw a stain on her clothing or on her body or whatever. De'aval gab de Tumah ketamim derabanan. Even though the Tumah of ketamim is also a din derabanan, like et le'et, but this is moving forward. If a woman sees a ketem, then her husband has a relationship with her husband. He is tamei tumat shivas. He's an avatum. We'll stop here, dedicate our learning. Remember, you're my father, Rav Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalman. Make it a great day.